Hi guys, welcome back to Daddy's Tab PH. Sorry kung may narinig siguro kayong aso na tumatahol ngayon. Hopefully hindi naman siya ganun ka lala. Ayan, so welcome back. It's been a while, no? And the reason why may bago tayong video ngayon is because my recent developments. I'll tell you more about it mamaya. But for now, I want to do this video, no? Because I want to learn DIY investing. And baka may mga interesado sa inyo, you want to take your personal finance to the next level. This could be useful, no? So first, syempre, papakilala ulit ako. So who am I? Then, ano yung objective nitong video na to? So, this video, essentially, ang objective niya is naghahanap ako ng isang robust o matatag na retirement portfolio na minimal yung fees, no? So that's why, that's one of the advantages pag DIY investing is na may minimize mo yung fees mo. Pero ikaw yung bahala sa sarili mo. So yun yung objective nito. Pero paano natin gagawin yun, di ba? And also a short background on my personal finance journey so far, no? So first slide, so medyo nakakahiya. Pero huwag na kayo mag-focus dun sa iba, dito na lang sa nakabilog, no? So I used this in a previous presentation dati. So I'm Gustav Cruz, so I am an electrical engineering graduate from UP Diliman, no? So I graduated BSEE back in 2014. I love sports. Pinaka-favorite ko is triathlon, no? So I started with yung mga bakal gym, then na-transition siya to running, cardio, then cycling, swimming, tas yun, naging triathlon na. And on the financial aspect naman, ako, I am involved in my family business. So, may pinamanang business sa amin ng lolo ko. Real estate, meron din na pinamana sa amin na mga ganyan na responsibilidad, no? So, I have some experience related to those. Graphic design, so as you can see, this is a hobby of mine. I like, exploring my creative side, no, and pushing myself to my limits when it comes to creativity, no. So graphic design, triathlon obviously, and yung business venture ko dati, yung Hexagon. So kung napanood niyo yung previous video ko dati, yun na ano kaya nabanggit ko yan. So let me just shrink itong ano ko, no. Let me just shrink itong isang video ko. So I just want to point out that I already have as someone who is, you know, very interested in the concept of money, no, personal finance. I already have the basics of personal finance covered given yung aking situation, yung aking upbringing as a child. I mentioned those dun sa aking previous video, no. And gusto ko siya i-take to the next level, no. So ano yun? What's that next level, no? So para saan ko ba 'to para saan ba 'tong personal finance series ko, no? So in 2020, we all know the coronavirus hit and lahat tayo apektado. Eh, into stocks investing na kayo, alam nyo na bumagsak talaga yung PSEI o yung stock market ng Philippines back in 2020. So, I want to re-evaluate my investment methodology right now kasi may something hindi maganda yung pakiramdam ko nung nakita ko nag-drop yung aking portfolio in 2020. So, ang aking methodology back then was just stock picking, no? Pero blue chips. So, when I say blue chips, yung mga robust and established companies in the Philippines, Philippines only. So, I was doing this thing called stock picking. So, kunwari, for this one, I like ABS-CBN kasi they seem like a good company. Or Ayala Land, Aboitiz Power, BDO, DDMP REIT, whatever. So ito yung mga ano, this is my current portfolio. I'm not ashamed to share it to you because this is my current level, no, when it comes to personal finance. But I want to transition to another level, no. So kasi medyo ang nahalata ko after 1 year of doing this is that nakakapagod mag-stock pick and napaka-exposed nung aking current portfolio to the Philippine setting, and I'll explain that later. So what I'm after some research, ang gusto ko maging transition ko is to transition to ETFs. Mamaya pag-usapan natin yan, or exchange traded fund, I think yun yung term yan. I'm not yet sure kasi I'm still learning the ropes on DIY investment. Portfolio allocation, so this means na hindi lang ako mag-rely sa and asset classes, isama na natin yung asset classes. This means hindi na ako mag-rely solely on stocks. I will have a different set of assets kasi stock, the term stock is just an asset class, no. So stock can be also called equities, and I want to get into other asset classes para mas maganda yung performance ng aking portfolio dahil sa panlasa ko bilang isang investor, no. I realized in 2020 na yung my way of doing investing is not suited do sa panlasa ko, risk versus reward. So as you can see, this is the trend, no, ng ating 10-year trend ni PSEI. So back in 2010, it's around 3,000, went way up all the way to 8,000, naglalaro siya sa 8,000 nung 2016 to 2020, and suddenly bam, 8,000, 4,623 kalahati, no. So imagine nung 2012, if you're a aspiring retiree, no, sabi mo 52 years old ka nitong 2012 and gusto mo mag-retire by 2020, tapos nakita mo nag-grow yung portfolio mo, tapos biglang nakita mo nang lahate, aw, sobrang stress ko ngayon kung yun yung yung gagamitin ko para buhayin ang sarili ko during the pandemic. So that's really bad kung 100 yung ng percent ng portfolio mo is into stock. So yun yung na-realize ko. So if that were me, stressed ako ngayon sobra, as in bawas yung buhay ko. So yun nga, it's a highly volatile portfolio. So yun, so given that, ito yung aking stock investing history, no. So not necessarily stock, pero yung aking investing history. So I have been into peer-to-peer lending and cooperatives. So yan. So magbibigay ako ng pera sa isang cooperative and they will lend it to people, say guro, sundalo, ganun. Then magbabalik sila ng dividend dun sa kanilang capital contribution members. So back in 2015 when I started working, I opened a BPI high dividend equity fund, which I realized was, yun nga, nung nire-review ko yung aking portfolio at saka yung aking managed fund na Widvul. Hindi ko na ibabanggitin kung anong company to, pero alam niyo yung may investment ka, ilalagay nila sa isang mixture ng stocks and bonds, tapos may kasamang say life insurance, ganun. Yun yung managed fund Widvul, VUL. So pwede nating i-develop ang ating financial literacy as we go along, no. So as you will observe as I go through this presentation na marami akong mga terms na binibitawan na unfamiliar ka, but let's not be afraid. I-take down lang natin yung mga terms na hindi tayo familiar, then let's research them after this video, no. So 2016 to 2020 I had a managed fund with Vol, then stocks and volatile assets 2020, no. So dito ako dito yung height ng aking stock picking spree, na hindi ko pala, when looking back, hindi ko nagustuhan, no. So yung for these two items nga pala, yung BPI high dividend fund at saka yung managed fund ko, na-realize ko naman dito, no, hindi ko siya gusto just because ang taas ng fees associated with them, and ang mas masakit pa is yung annual. It's deducted to my current value ng aking fund annually. It's the cost of trusting your money with these people, no? So I don't know about you, but nung narinig ko na na-realize ko na ganun pala talaga siya, bigla akong napaisip, no? So as you can see, itong fee, so sabihin mo 1.5% ng iyong ng value. So sabihin mo nag-invest ako ng 100,000 dito, tatanggalin nila 1.5%. So 98,500 agad yung nabawasan agad yung investment mo, 'di ba? And para sa akin, that does not sit well, because yung 100,000 na yon, binawasan na yun eh. Binawasan na yung gobyerno, kinuha na ng tax, kinuha na ng SSS PhilHealth Pag-ibig. Ayoko pang dagdagan yung bawas doon, 'di ba? So that's what where I'm coming from, no. But I know na these people naman are specializing in finance, but you know, it still doesn't sit well with me. There has to be another way. So yun. So para saan ko ba ngayon? Para saan ko ba 'to ginagawa, 'di ba? The purpose of this personal finance series, no. So mainly, I want to find the appropriate retirement portfolio and share my findings along the way, no. So yun, gusto kong makuha ng isang retirement portfolio na kapag bumagsak dahil sa isang significant event yung economy, hindi ganoon ka as in, pwede, expected naman na bumaba, pero not as much, di ba? Hindi naman 50%, kahit mga 10%, yung acceptable, di ba? As a retiree. Yun. Ang next is, learn how to manage my own portfolio by becoming a DIY investor. I want to get rid of those fees, no? Because I respect yung money na naiipon ko post-tax and post-contributions. So ito yung cost for doing DIY. Kailangan mo mag-research, no? And on how to do it. But later on, I think we can do it in a simple manner. And lastly, para kanino ko to ginagawa, ito. After 1 year, thank you very much, guys. Nakaabot tayo ng 1,300 views sa aking personal 5 keys to personal finance, and this comment from Sir Aaron Balagtas is also a trigger kung bakit ko gusto gawin to, no. Sir, salamat sa paggawa ng video na ito. Sir, sana soon pag okay na ang lahat, makagawa po kayo ng seminar. God bless po. So eto na yun, Aaron. So thank you very much for your kind words, no. Talagang tumatak sa akin to. Thank you very much. So you're one of the reasons why I'm doing this right now. So yun, we're talking about retirement portfolios right now, di ba? So ano ba yung criteria ko for my retirement portfolio, no? So I just want it to be simple. So kanina, pinakita ko sa inyo na nag-stock pick ako, di ba? I don't want to do that anymore. Parang mag-rely ako, overexpose ako sa, as you can see kung pinansin nyo kanina, overexpose ako sa Aboitiz, sa Max. Ganun. Ayoko na yan ganun. Gusto ko simple lang. Titingnan ko lang yung portfolio ko once a month. Tapos hindi ako mag-alala kung ang isang company ay mag-bankrupt, hindi ako overexposed. Ganun. Simple lang siya. So I want a chunk of from everything na from a certain asset class, no. So next is low volatility. Ayoko na nangangalahati yung portfolio ko kapag bumagsak ang ekonomiya. So kasi kapag retired na ako, I will withdraw from that fund monthly and quarterly, di ba? So I want to improve my risk versus reward metric, di ba? So yung isa yon, and it will not dip too much in bad economic environments. So yan yung mga low volatility, I want that, and it's supposed to be sustainable. The growth of the portfolio should sustain the withdrawals, no? So may tinatawag tayo na safe withdrawal rate. So that's a term right there. So kung yun ang gusto ko, kung yun yung criteria ko, ano ba yung naiisip ko na solution, no? So what I came up with is this. So let me just turn off my camera for a bit so makita nyo, no? So I want to diversify my portfolio outside of the Philippine stock market, no? Dati kasi as beginners, we all begin sa call financial, 'di ba? Kasi yan ang pinakasikat na way to invest. And it's already a good start, believe me, lalo na pag maaga ka pa. Pero if you're in the wealth preservation stage, it's better to diversify your portfolio. I'll explain more maybe in the future videos or later in this presentation, no. And simplify the maintenance of the portfolio, no. So instead of stock picking na parang masyado ng madami akong stocks dito sa certain company to, kailangan kong balansehin, I want to transition to macro asset class allocation like yung PSEI. In general, hindi na ako magpipili ng individual companies sa and sa US, kunwari, sa US yung Nasdaq, parang counterpart siya ng PSEI and the S&P 500. So yung Nasdaq is more on technology based if my memory serves me correct, no. And other stocks ano stock markets in the ano around the world, no, not just the United States. Although the US is the biggest stock capitalization sa buong mundo. So that's where I intend to begin, no. Now, sige, dito tayo sa stock market. Okay, stock market companies behave the same way. Also, okay, so bakit hindi nag-work ang ano, no, ang stock picking based on what I found out, no? It's because these companies, itong mga nakikita nyo sa under PSEI, yung current stocks ko, they are all correlated, no? In a way, not fully correlated, but they move the same way. So when I say that, kapag gumalaw ang PSEI index, so tulad nito, pag gumalaw tong PSEI na to, lahat, you can be assured na yung mga companies na pinili ko, they will move the same way as the PSEI. It's because they are part of the PSEI. They compose the PSEI, diba? They, ano, yun. Okay. Sorry about that, daddy duties. Yan. So, where was I ba? Let's see. Yeah, as yung, like I said, kapag correlated yung mga, correlated lahat ng mga, ano, no, ng mga companies dun sa PSEI. So, it's useless. Kung hindi ka naman na day trader and hindi mo i-assess individually itong mga companies na nakalagay dito ngayon, mas magandang bumili ka na lang ng PSEI. So, pero yun nga, ang the thing is, kapag bumili ka ng PSEI is may mga trust fees, no? So, that's what we're trying to avoid. So, how can you buy all these without the high fees, right? So, ano bang mga acceptable na fees? Like, 0.5. So ako may tinatawag ako when researching may tinatawag na FM ETF, no. So yung FM ETF it's a kind of stock. Let me just check kung nandito siya. Ayan. So ayan. This is FM ETF, no. So it's a kind of stock. Let me just increase yung size para makita niyo mabuti. So it's a stock, yung FM ETF na tinetrace yung PSEI, pero ano siya, hindi siya managed fund. So you can buy it and sila nang bahala mag-split nung ano, sila nang bahala mag-split nung sila nang magbahala mag-buy ng companies for and has a lower fee annually compared doon sa mga managed funds. So yun siya. So that's the power of ETFs. They have lower fees because minimal yung management doon sa fund. So, pero itong All Pinoy Golden Ratio Portfolio, this is for another episode. Ni-research ko pa to eh. This is where we can, where you balance your funds. So, yan. Stop picking. Then, let's proceed to ETFs. Parang so, sinasabi ko ngayon, ang solution ngayon is ETFs. For me, ah. Kasi yun nga, they're all correlated. Say, kunwari, kung familiar kayo sa coal financial, ang mga, may categories kasi yung mga, ano, may categories kasi yung mga sectoral markets, no, sa Philippine Stock Exchange or sa Philippine Stock Market. So, kunwari, sa financial na sector, you have BPI, Union Bank, East West, RCBC, PNB, di ba? Ano itong chip? China Bank siguro yan. MBT, Security Bank, tsaka BDO. So, they're all correlated, di ba? Parang kapag bumagsak yung finance market, most likely, it's because of these guys, di ba? So, etong correlation table, sinasabi lang niya na may, ano, I don't want to get into the nitty-gritty of correlation, no? But for now, for the sake of simplicity, etong correlation na to, if this value of correlation is 1, then this time series behave similarly. So, kunwari, yung financials is has a 0.847219 na correlation with the entire Philippine Stock Exchange. So most 84.84, that's a very high correlation, no? So it will behave just like the total stock market ng Philippines, no? So say sabihin natin dito sa holdings, yung holdings ito yung mga big conglomerates nila, MVP, nila Ramon Ang, 'di ba? You have the Gokongwei, so kunwari MPI, Metro Pacific, Aboitiz Equity, so yung mga Aboitiz, Ayala, DMC, San Miguel, 'di ba? So yan yung mga, when you say holdings, they own different kinds of businesses, no? So conglomerate sila. So it's 0.886 ang taas, highly correlated with the Philippine stock market and 79. So you get the point, no? So ito yan. So the industrials with respect to the all shares, the financials, the holdings, etc., etc., etc. So yan. So ito yung mga correlations nila, no? So you can check that out. So thank you to Mr. Cesar Rufino for this document, no? So isang challenge talaga sa Philippine setting is ang konti ng nakikita ko na papers regarding when it comes to portfolio management. When you're going DIY, mas marami sa US, they're more serious about this. So yun nga, so mas inclined ako na mag-create ng portfolio na may US based din. But it doesn't mean na I will leave the entire Philippine market. I still want to diversify my money between the Philippine market and the US market. So yun siya. So that's correlation, no? So kapag 1 yung correlation, say all shares to all shares is 1, malabang kasi correlated sila, they behave similarly, no? So that's 1. Yung 1 ang pero pwede ring negative, no? Kapag umangat yung, say kunwari, negative 1 yung financial with respect to the all shares, so ibig sabihin, pag umangat yung Philippine stock market, negative naman, pababa naman yung financial. So pwede ka ring maging negatively correlated. So yan. So from negative 1 to 1 ang value ng correlation in the financial universe. So that's it. I think that's enough background. Ako, I don't like long videos din talaga, but I believe this is a niche video, so yung mga audience ko dito will be very niche, those who really want control, no, over their hard-earned money. So who is this presentation for? So let's do this. You may have already started. So maybe this these statements describe you, no? At least one, di ba? You may have already started your investment journey, but you want to take things to the next level. Sounds like me, di ba? So kung pinanood mo na yung previous video ko, you save more than what you earn. So check yon. You already have the earning mindset. Check. And you want to start investing, no? Pero you don't know where to start, di ba? Nagsisimula ka pa lang, down ang market, the perfect time. So one thing, isingit ko na lang din for my financial advisor friends. Don't entice people to invest in the market kapag mataas na yung stock market. Entice them when the market is low. Yun lang. Quick tip lang doon sa mga financial advisor friends ko para mas maganda yung ating service, no? Sa ating mga kapwa Pilipino. So, kung beginner ka and you just watch my video about the 5 basic principles, you want to get started, pwede. But you need to catch up in terms of financial, ang pinaka-challenge talaga dito is keeping up dun sa mga terminologies na ginagamit natin. So, mamaya may solution tayo dyan. So, third is like me, namulat ang iyong mata sa pandemic. Ayaw mo yung feeling na, oh, shoot, yung mga investments ko nang alahate. Biglang bumaba yung paper value ng portfolio ko dahil sa pandemic. This is for you because we're going to explore a robust retirement portfolio. I mean retirement, pwede kang magpasasa dito sa portfolio mo na to. So, pwede rin, active investor ka. This is not me, pero if you're an active investor, like a day trader, na tinitignan mo every day kung ano yung correlation, you read the news, the financial statements, everything ng isang company just to make profits, di ba? Overbought, yung mga RSI, Relative Strength Index, MACD, yung mga ganun, di ba? Yung mga may indicators ka if you're a day trader. Pero gusto mo maging passive investor, you just want to buy an ETF for total stock market, you want to buy an ETF for, say, US stock market, for bonds, for the money market. We will talk more about this asset class in the future. Pero gusto mong maging passive investor, you just want to have one of each asset class and allocate a certain percentage sa portfolio mo, then withdraw. This is also for you, no? If you want to transition from an active to a passive investor. So last, you already finished wealth accumulation. Congratulations. Kung ikaw ay isang mag-retire na tao kasi you already won in the game of life, you are looking to put your hard-earned money into a less volatile portfolio pero with still high returns. This is for you, no? I think it's possible kasi if you want to preserve yung ano mo, if you want to preserve yung ang typical portfolio ngayon ng isang retiree is about 60-40, 60 stocks, 40 bonds, right? So you may have heard of that kung intermediate level personal finance person ka. But there's a better way of doing it, no? So I'm currently reading through some literature and we'll discover them as we go along with demonstration, of course. So how do we do the demonstration, diba? Mamaya, pag-usapan natin. So, eto, you can just pause this video and kasi I don't want to exceed 30 minutes, no? So, is this video presentation introducing the DIY investor, eto yung mga traits niya. And I understand na this is not for everybody. If you are willing to pay the fees, management fees, just because you don't want to, it's not practical to research, diba, and learn about these things, but you have lots of things you want to do and it's acceptable to give 1.5% of your money to a fund manager each year, that's fine, that's totally fine. DIY is not for everyone, we are all created different, no? So that's just that. Pero if you are the like me, and I will create a segment for in the future videos to introduce financial jargons, no? So ito mga some of the terms na pwede mong simulan, no? Now story behind this. So back in May 2021, I had a very healthy baby boy, very blessed kami ni Mrs. Tab PH, Mrs. Bakuryo, tawag ko sa kanya. Ayan, so we have a healthy baby boy and his name is Levi. Yon. And after 2 months pinanganak si Levi, si Lola medyo umagresive si Lola. May surprise lump sum siya, nagmature yung isang investment niya. 200,000 worth of claims, no, for her contribution. Hindi naman niya alam na may ganun pala siya, nakalimutan niya na. Eh dati pa daw niya mga bata-bata pa daw siya eh. So she wants to allocate the 200,000 for Levi's education fund, no, to be used 19 years from now. So may isa kaming kinausap na financial advisor. The fund chosen is an 80% international bonds and 20% equity stocks. But I want to talk and suggest dun sa financial advisor na yun na to split the 200,000 into dalawang 100,000 na funds just so we can compare performances ng iba't ibang klase ng portfolio allocation. So as ito na yung nakikita natin when you say asset class, yung asset class ng bonds 80%, yung equities or stocks is 20%. So that's a certain type of portfolio. Then you have the 60-40 na mas aggressive dahil sa nature ng stocks and yung nature ng bonds, di ba? So 60% equities and 40% bonds. Baka may ganun. So pwedeng i-split to just to compare performances throughout the years, no? And sa a caveat, ako rin, at the same time, I am trying to figure out ano bang magandang retirement portfolio composition given yung mga pinag-uusapan natin kanina, no? So, yun. Nag-present yung financial advisor at that time and I want to test it out, no? I want to test out the best retirement portfolio because yung fund chosen, meron siyang quarterly, may binibigay siya na 1%. So parang 4% of the portfolio goes back to you annually. Kasi 1% per quarter, 4 times a year. Yan. So, ibig sabihin, so parang pwede mong tratuhin yung 1% na yun na yun yung iyong, ipang kabubuhay doon sa quarter na yun. So, pwede nating i-compare kung if I continuously get money from my portfolio, will it be able to sustain its value? And will it be able to stand the test of times in different market environments? So, abangan natin yon. So, ito yung challenge ko ngayon. So, kailangan ko mag-ipon ng 200,000 and I will allocate those in different types of portfolios as well. And we will compare their performance through time while increasing your financial literacy, no? So, yun yung gagawin natin. So, this is what the video is all about. So, may 400,000 tayo for Levi. we will withdraw 1% per quarter and see who has the best performance as we go along. So this is an empirical study. So meron tayong hopefully makatulong to sa mga nag-research, no? Bibigyan natin sila ng kaalaman about portfolio management. So until then, let's build your financial literacy, no? So ako, ang ginagawa ko right now is gumagawa ko ng personal finance glossary. Lahat ng mga hindi ko naintindihan in this video na terms. So kunwari, ikaw pa hindi ka naintindihan, you just put it in an Excel file and use Investopedia, no? So and tinatype mo lang. Huwag mong i-copy paste. Mas ma-retain mo siguro 'yon kapag tinype mo yung word na 'yon. So, 'yun. So kunwari sa correlation. So yung word, featured word natin ngayon is correlation. If you want to, know the formal definition of correlation, look it up in Investopedia and type it in your personal finance glossary. Tapos pag-usapan natin siya in the next video. So I guess that's it. So thank you very much. I know this is a very long podcast. Sorry. This is a very long video. I want the video to be less than 10 minutes. So hopefully in the future videos, just bear with me as we start this. But in the future videos, unti-unti natin siya, ha? We will make them shorter, I promise. So thank you very much. Daddy Stab out.